And what she was able to do was get the World Bank to invest $300 million
mm-hmm.
into the Nigerian mortgage refinancing company
okay.
to start an avalanche of 10,000 mortgages
okay.
to kickstart the market.
Mm-hmm.
And then she's brought in a system of governments
yes.
to ensure the governance, to ensure that these mortgages get to the people that need them.
That's the intended.
I will be the first person to raise my hand
okay.
when someone has said to me that they want a property
uh-huh.
and I've pointed them to the Nigerian mortgage refinance
okay.
company and they don't get the loan because it's not helping me.
Uh-huh.
It should be to make homes affordable.
Yes.
I'm bringing down the price, but mm-hmm. still people need the mortgage.
Absolutely.
The traditional mortgage that we know in the
yeah.
diaspora. And they're providing 15, 20-year mortgages
okay.
in interest rates that are in the teens, not the 20s. You see, in Nigeria, you can get mortgages at 20-something.
Yes.
So these are in the low teens,
mm-hmm.
depending on person's
yes.
need. And so the World Bank has merged, has brought in lower interest rates.
Uh-huh.
Obviously, they've got to be high enough to take account of a Nigerian country,
yes.
political risk,
yeah.
currency risk, and
all
those
that,
things.
Yeah, yeah.
But they're still... makes
still,
it affordable.
Okay. We have another caller on the line. Hello, do I have Irulu on the line?
Good morning to you.
Good morning and welcome to the program. Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Buckinghamshire.
Oh, lovely. So what is your question to Adrian this morning?
First of all, permit me to rename Adrian Olakunle. If he's from Oakland, I expect him to have a Yoruba name. So permit me to say Olakunle.
Oh, you didn't ask him.
Well,
ask him if he has a Yoruba name.
Right. On that note, Adrian, I would love to know your Yoruba name so I can celebrate you. That's my first comment. May I carry on?
Please do.
Thank you. The second thing is, I had the privilege last Friday
mm-hmm.
of being at the Niger High Commission, and I want to congratulate Ben TV and Nido for the very successful occasion.
Mm-hmm.
That left me with a big question because at that event, the government program wasn't actually talked about. We heard about Asho, Homes and Loans, we heard about, of course, Nido. But my understanding, so the question can be to either of you, is that the government scheme closed on the 5th of September and 10,000 mortgages were already given. And the new one is going to be reopened. So I don't know when that is going to be. And I don't know how that fits into what Adrian is saying, because if the government scheme that you said was launched by Ngozi Nwejala has already, the first phase, if I can use that, has closed. So when are they going to reopen the next lot of mortgages? And how does that relate to you? I know that you're not part of the government scheme. I know you are actually marketing your own property.
Okay.
At the end of the day, you're also talking about mortgages. So I would like either of you to clarify that for me.
All right.
Okay.
Let Adrian clarify that. Adrian.
Okay, let me fire away. It's Erelu, is it?
Yes.
Okay. So you can call me Tux, Tokumbo, if you really want to.
I get Tokumbo.
So, but in relation, now very seriously about this, I was with the chief executive
mm-hmm.
of the Nigerian mortgage refinancing company on Friday of this week. I also went to the High Commission at the event that you were at, but I was with the chief executive, and my understanding from him is that the scheme is not closed yet. So I do urge you to go to their website. But I was with him on Friday and Saturday.
Okay.
And he is in transit back to Nigeria, but I do not believe that it's closed. Secondly, the scheme with Asso Savings that launched at the event at the Nigerian High Commission that was recommended by the Nigerian High Commissioner to members of the diaspora is open under that scheme. So anyone that applies under the scheme that he was talking for about is within the Nigerian mortgage refinance company. So I don't think the doors have been closed yet, and I really urge you to go to the to search the Nigerian mortgage refinancing company's details.
Adrian, we will have to go because the news is coming on shortly. But your final word, what will your final word be for everybody that's listening and that has tuned in today?
Well, first of all, there's hope.
Mm-hmm.
Things have changed. Things are changing. there's a wind of change. We have some very powerful women who are leading the government, and they're leading it in the right direction. The second is perseverance. Mm. And I think perseverance is the watchword. There are lots of opportunities in Nigeria. Absolutely. There are good and the bad, but in the end, those good opportunities outweigh, I think, the bad.
The bad. Thank you so much. You've heard from Adrian Ogun there about Adriano Properties and his experience in Nigeria. And indeed, he has 200 units of property available in Lagos. He also has He has 200 units in Abuja, and he has 9 in Lagos that are available. So if you're interested, I believe they can go on your website.
Yes,
there.
That's right.
www.adrianoproperties.com. There's no .ng at the end?
No.
Okay, just checking that. So, you know, you can go and find out online how to get in touch with Adrian. You may want to also offer him some land. Whatever it may be, he seems to be the man. He has lived here over the years. He took his time away from his very nice career. He was doing very well to go to Nigeria and to learn how to build, and he's ensuring that he does it to standards.
Yes.
So there is hope, as he says. If you're interested, www.adrianoproperties.com. We are going to go off now. The news comes on, but I'll be right back soon after the news, so don't go away. Stay with me. See you soon.